people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who dwelt in a land of gloom, a light has shone. That light is the light of Christ. The light of Christ. All of these lights in the darkness of this night symbolize the light of Christ. And St. John tells us the light came into the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. The darkness did not overcome the light. Rick Hilton found these chandeliers in his closet. I don't know where. Are they from St. Cecilia's? They're absolutely beautiful. So, what better night? The light. The light came into the world. The light of Christ. Hope. Hope is the virtue that gives us a vision. It gives us a way to live regardless of the evening news. Isn't that good news? It gives us this vision that God will keep his promises, that God will keep his word. That's what hope is. It's not a question of optimism or pessimism. That goes up and down like the stock market. But hope is known, sure and certain, that God has promised it and God will do it. And he promised that he would send his Messiah, and here he is, this little guy, 2,000 years ago, the Messiah for his Jewish people and the Savior of the entire world and universe. He promised that he would send his Messiah. But this little guy promised that he would come again in glory. He's going to keep his word. But we pray it all the time. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. That's going to happen. He will come again in glory, and God's will is going to be done on earth as it is in heaven. That's hope. It's certain. It's sure. Someday there's going to be peace on earth. He will come again in glory and fully establish the reign of God, the kingdom of God. Someday there will be peace on this earth. Someday there'll be no more poverty or hunger or homelessness. No more refugees. It's going to happen. Someday there will be justice and respect for all peoples and all nationalities. It's going to happen. The kingdom is going to come. It's going to be certain, sure. Someday every child will be received and accepted and loved and wanted and cared for. That's hope. God's going to keep his word. You know, he's little. And great things usually start small. Mother Teresa, did you know that she's going to be canonized next year, 2016? So she'll be Saint Mother Teresa. She was little, but she said this. She said, do small things well. Do little things faithfully, for in there lies your strength. Just doing small things, little things, like coming here tonight. Just do this faithfully. In this lies your strength. And it's amazing, if we continue to do little things, then the world's going to change. God's going to change the world. if we are faithful in little things. I want to just give two examples tonight that most of you my age will remember. You remember when you were back in the 50s and 40s, at the end of Sunday Mass, we would pray the Hail Holy Queen, three Our Fathers, and three Hail Marys, and we were going to convert Russia. You remember that? And little Catholic kids getting down there on their knees. We get on our knees, and we were going to take down atheistic communism. And we believed it. That's hope. And we're going to say these prayers, and God's going to do this. It's going to happen. Well, you can't remember that. You're too young. But you remember that. We prayed for the conversion of Russia. We prayed that atheistic communism would fall apart. And God brought it about. Back in 1989, and this is just my humble opinion, but St. John Paul II had a lot to do with it. President Ronald Reagan had a lot to do with it. They were friends. They had both been assassinated. And they both were instruments in helping to bring down the Iron Curtain. Remember Churchill and the Iron Curtain and Harry Truman brought down the Iron Curtain and brought down the Berlin Wall without a shot. Without a shot. That's hope, folks. That's hope. But we've got to have hope. These little things. Just keep praying, trusting God, that this world is going to change. The kingdom is going to come, regardless of what the evening news tells us. This is the Savior right here. The other example I want to point out, remember the Bishop Desmond Tutu from South Africa, the Anglican bishop, and he was bishop in the middle of apartheid, an ugly system where the black people were physically separated from the white people. They lived in their own townships, their own ghettos, and it was an awful. Into the 20th century, this was still going on, apartheid, and the believers, the Christians in South Africa would get together and they would pray for an end to apartheid. And they had no weapons, they had no armies. And they would pray, and then they would light candles. And they would put candles in their windows. You see the candles in the windows? So in their homes, in their churches, in their shops, they would put candles symbolizing that they were praying for an end to apartheid. And the South African government, I'm not making this up, banned candles in windows. It was an act of insurrection. They banned candles in windows because it was a sign of hope. And then the atmosphere changed, and South Africa began to see that what they were doing was not only wrong, evil, it was stupid. And apartheid came to an end. And Nelson Mandela, who had been in jail for 15, 17, 18 years, he became president of South Africa, and he invited his jailers to come to his inauguration. That's hope, folks. That's hope. That's hope for the human race, that prayer and candles can make that huge difference. So when you see all of these, this is Christ. All over the towns here, all over Alton, all over Wolfboro, you see all these lights. That's the light of Christ. Those are the Christmas lights, the lights of hope. And I keep telling you this, Christmas has just begun today, just started, and it's going to go on for another 17 days until the baptism of our Lord on January the 10th. So please keep your lights lit. Keep your Christmas trees lit. Keep your candles lit. Keep praying and keep hoping. And it's going to happen. It's going to happen. God is going to win. He's going to come again in glory. A sure and certain hope, without a doubt. So the news is good. It can't get any better than that. That God has become one of us. We're united to God. The human race is united to God. We share in his life. And he's coming again in glory to fully establish peace and justice and love. What a. It all happens at Christmas. It's all here. I get excited about it. It's all happening. And we're part of it. Pray and light candles.